Chances are you've wasted no time getting ready for your big day. I know you've been working for months.
I have.
Your wedding's not until June. But if you haven't started, with spring just around the corner, now's the time to get started.
And as I found out, when you're planning, you better start saving, because get this, the average cost of a wedding is $26,000. Neil, the dad of two daughters does not like to hear this.
I just heard a bunch of dads in the Piedmont go, oh my.
Scream, yes. With such a big price tag, though, more couples are turning to wedding insurance for a bit of extra security.
Your wedding is a special day you'll remember forever, from the pictures.
So we offer videography, photography, and makeup. Our biggest package is $6,000, and that includes all three.
To the beautiful flowers.
Probably the average wedding is about $1,000, $800 to $1,000, and that's bouquets, corsages, boutonnieres, centerpieces.
To the perfect cake.
Our price range start at $350 a serving, and it goes up from there. We do custom cakes, so therefore, it depends on what you order. Of course, a cake that's really hard to do is going to cost a lot more than cakes that are real simple.
Add in the dress, tuxedos, church, reception, and food, things start to add up.
Weddings today are big financial events for the most part.
Tim Ward is in the business of ensuring your special day is stress-free. He's not a wedding planner or a caterer. He's an insurance agent promoting something called wedding insurance.
I think there's been a recent press article that the average wedding is $26,000 today. So that means that half of them are more expensive than that.
Ward says coverage has been available for the last 20 years, but it's just starting to be used more often. Basically, it's event cancellation coverage.
It could be a death in the family. It could be a snowstorm in New England that paralyzes the airlines, so the wedding party can't get here for the wedding. It could be someone called up for military duty unexpectedly after the wedding's been scheduled. Anything that causes you to lose money where you've put deposits down, you've rented tuxedos, you've done a lot of things, hired a band, and you're going to lose that money.
Insurance covers other problems too. Like in the event you have to move the wedding due to unforeseen circumstances, you're covered. If someone at your party gets a little too rowdy and damages the catering hall, you're covered. And if the bride or groom decides they don't want to go through with the wedding?
Cold feet, not covered. Sorry.
As for how much you'll spend on wedding insurance?
The cost of the premiums on these things are very reasonable, as low as $200 for a policy, and they'll generally go up to $1,000.
Now, 2 million weddings are performed each year in the U.S. Currently, fewer than 1% of those weddings are insured. Van, have you started saving for your daughter's wedding?
I guess. I mean, we're dealing with college right now.
One thing at a time, huh?
That's right. Let's talk about